breaking update now coming from the national capital. All India Institute of Medical Sciences, AIIMS, has issued a stern warning to the protesting doctors. Let me straight away go across to my colleague Tejshree joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Tejshree, so there is an office memo that has been issued by the AIIMS registrar to all the resident doctors, and that says that there should be no activity in terms of a strike, dharna or demonstration around the vicinity of AIIMS.
Well, absolutely. Let me tell you that the protest at AIIMS Hospital was supposed to be held at 1 p.m. today, but now we'll have to see that what next step does this resident doctors take, because we have seen now this particular circular that's being put out where they've said that no protest or strike or dharna will be taking place, not just within the premises, but as you rightly mentioned, in the vicinity as well. So what will be the next step of the AIIMS resident doctors? We'll have to see that, because yesterday there were protests in several hospitals. And currently I'm reporting from Safdarjung. We are seeing protest in RML also, and then it was supposed to be held at AIIMS also. But then they have issued a stern warning as well that if they continue or if they decide still to carry forward their protest, then action will be taken. And in fact, they've also alerted the head of the departments of all the several respective departments that if any resident doctors sit on the protest, then strict action will be taken against him or her.
Right, Tejshree, thank you for the moment for joining us with all of those details. Let me also now go across to my colleague Deepak Bopanna, who's joining us live from Bengaluru. Deepak, over to you. Tell us, what is the situation in Bengaluru, where you are, and what is it that the doctors are demanding?
Well, it's the day two of the protest here at Nimans Hospital, a very big hospital here, a hospital, of course, that caters to the needs of thousands of patients on a regular basis. Here they are saying, until a central act is brought to the fore, until the CBI takes over the investigation, this protest will continue. You can see hundreds of them who have come in here. This is day two, and some thought-provoking posters that have been put up. One I could read here, it says, I'm a female doctor, and if I get a ward call at 2 a.m., should I go? Am I afraid? That's the kind of doubts that this incident has raised in the minds of the doctors. And they are saying that the government should do enough so that an incident like this does not occur once again. Let me take across some of the questions to some of the doctors. This is a very thought-provoking placard that you've held. And many of the doctors, especially female doctors in the country, are going through an emotion like this. Now, if you could take us through once again, what is the primary demand of
our primary demand is to ensure justice to the deceased person and her family. She was one among us. She went for duty, and when she went for duty, next day her parents are knowing that she was raped and she was dead. And the authorities were trying to cover it up with suicide. We don't know who did this, but it was so brutal. And now they have brought a guy. We don't know how much truth.
Right. So a central act is something that the doctors in Bengaluru are demanding. Deepak, thank you for the moment for joining us with all of those details. We'll keep coming back to you for more on this. And this is going to be your top story the whole day today on Times Now. Heading into a very, very short break. Lots lined up for you on the other side. Don't go anywhere.